Alright, hello everyone, and welcome back to my Roma Surrectum 2 campaign. Let's get this show on the road, so to speak. I'm still pondering over a few particular strategic plans in the grand strategy map, but all that doesn't really matter until we fight this actual major battle. So we're going to take these men, led by General Sextus, and we're going to engage this Gadir army, with our reinforcements from Gadir as well. And they're going to face us. We are going to be facing Balshik Bilbilis. Alright, anywho, that fellow, hopefully a soon-to-be-dead Carthaginian. Now, I'm not taking a look at his army, just because that might toggle on the auto reinforcements, and I don't want that, actually, so we're going to go ahead and fight this battle on the battle map, so I'll see you there.
Romans! Countrymen! Today is a day for brave deeds! Today is a proud day to be Roman! Today we face the mighty Carthaginians, brave men and worthy foes. Our task today is a noble one, to preserve the town and its people. We outnumber them by a large margin, but this may drive them to foolhardy defiance. Be careful. The enemy deserve no better than to be shot down. Let us do this and conserve our strength. Last time I fought those men, we were unlucky. It is now time to take revenge for that defeat.
You never fought them.
To fear us anew.
Alright, so here is my setup. Just a main core of troops right here, just so I'm a little bit more maneuverable when it comes to the battlefield. Two wings of Aravisi medium cavalry to kind of flank around. And let's start the battle. Now, what do we have here? Yeah, they're setting up on the hill, and we need to take a look at what sort of missile units they have. They have nothing all that scary, actually, and nothing that can really threaten my Balearic slingers. So, what I'm going to do, I think, is set up my troops around here and move towards them with this path right here. So I'll get back to you once I'm all set up. Alright, well, this battle was disappointing. They're fleeing from the battlefield. I guess the numbers were too much for them, so I'm going to see if I can't pick off a few stragglers. I'll see you at the results. Alright, well, that was a clear victory with no losses. They just ran away. I guess I don't have to worry about fighting them now. Well, at least not yet. Now, alas, they ran back into Tingi, and unfortunately, I can't deal with them yet because my troops can't move any further, and these guys are too weak to kind of deal with this army right here. Plus, I wouldn't have anyone to garrison it with. So instead, Decimus Fabius Maximus is going to head over here and chill out in Gadir just for a little bit. Who do we have here? A Carthaginian assassin? Oh my. We're going to have to deal with him somehow. Alright. Well then. I'll get back to you. Alright, so we have a few things to do. First of all, here in Roma, Marcus Fabius Maximus here is now 18. I think that's old enough to govern the settlement. And right now I have two open ones on kind of Italy, well, Sicily specifically. We have Lilybaum and Agrica. And if we look at the trade details as far as income goes, it looks like Agrica is making more money in overall income, 523 compared to 420. So I think we're going to reward him with Agrica. He has some decent stats. In addition, he is a medium share tax farmer already, which is pretty great. So we're going to have him head over that away. I wonder if we have some ships that could ferry him down there relatively quickly. We have one here in Capua. Let's use it, I suppose. So we'll have him drop off over in Capua. Head on down to the north here by Lilybaum. And he'll head over to Agrica itself. Oh, and he didn't quite make it, which is a shame, but that's okay. He'll get there next turn. And actually, before I forget, let's just quickly go ahead and have our diplomat talk with the Greeks and see if they want a ceasefire. We'll offer just making a single payment as an offer, see if they want anything. No, they have nothing in return. They don't want to discuss anything, so that's fine. Typically, I said I kind of like want a house rule, whereas I don't lay claim to a city unless its nation is I have a ceasefire with that nation, which is why I haven't been building in Pulentia or Saguntum or Bicor or Carthago Nova or Gadir, because I want a ceasefire with the Carthaginians to kind of make my occupation nice and legal. But with the Greek city-states, well, they were just that, city-states. So really, although they were united with their culture and some politics, and I'm sure they might raise an army to try to reclaim it, and also for the fact of the rule of fun, so to speak, I think I'm going to just take Syracuse as my own and just say, this is now Roman. So I'm going to kind of circumvent that house rule for the sake of, I don't know, for the sake of it being fun to me, I guess. Alright, so since the Greeks don't want peace just yet, I see no reason why I can't sink their stupid navy. So we're going to go ahead and attack with a clear victory, sinking them to the bottom of the sea. This unit here is going to go ahead and continue to blockade that port, while we're going to retrain our boats here in Tarentum. Alright, so I have two options in dealing with my main strategic plans. I can do things historical, or I can do things unhistorical. Historically speaking, I would continue to push into Carthage, forcing them for a ceasefire, claim my Spanish and Iberian holdings, and then at a small period of time declare a second war, and then completely wipe out the Carthaginians. That does sound like fun. And I think, that's the operative word, I might be able to get a ceasefire if I manage to beat this army here, take Tingi, maybe send another army down to their eastern holdings in Africa, take another town, and use those two to barter a ceasefire with maybe some added money. Now, the second option, the unhistorical one, is dealing with the Galaci. And in order to do that, I would deal with a natural stopgap, which would be this Strait of Gibraltar right here. I couldn't justify to myself by just sticking one ship here, because I feel that that would be an exploit. But if I sent an entire navy over, like a half stack of triremes, that could justify them patrolling and preventing any sort of land crossing. So I'm debating between the two. So stopgapping the Carthaginians here, and focusing on wiping out the Galaci, then I don't have to worry about an entire front, and then I can focus on the Carthaginians completely. They are relatively weak. They do just have their Africa holdings. They no longer have any Iberia or the Balearics or anything else. It's very, very tempting to do. But to tell you the truth, I will have to wait till next turn to actually do that plan. So what I'm going to do, this is actually what I'm going to do. I'm going to start moving this navy over, and I'm going to continue to finish up this turn just doing a bunch of bits and bobs. What I would really like you to do is tell me in the comment section what you think is best. I'm not trying to be populist, and I'm not trying to, you know, not make this hard decision myself, but I really like to make my LP somewhat interactive, and some of you guys have some great strategic minds, and I really would like a second, a third, a fourth, a fifth opinion on all of this, because it's really actually killing me, because there are pros and cons to both approaches. Anyways, enough of that kind of blathering. I'll finish up this turn and end this little session before I hit the end turn button. Alright, I still have this fleet. I was going to bring it down to protect Syracuse from the Greeks, but right now I'm actually going to stick it right here. I do have these quinquiremes right here, so they can maybe deal with anything that Carthage might throw at me, and if the Greeks do come around this way, I can quickly swing them around and deal with them. Alright, so since we've found a spy here, we want to protect Decimus Fabius Maximus. And the best way to protect him is to send our own spy into Gadir to kind of prevent an infiltration by Mutinis Surxina. And I'm going to try to recruit my own assassin to deal with him, because that's an element of this game I haven't dealt with yet. And it might be pretty important. Now, I do like to keep a bit of a war chest, and for those of you who are familiar with my previous LPs, my Rome Total War LPs at least, I like to keep a war chest, something in the bank that's about 500 per territory that I control. I control 22 regions, so I want to have at least 1,100, so I can spend about 1,100 gold, or denarii in this case, and I already know what my first priority will be. All of my, not every settlement has a governor, then of course you get penalized on that. So I'm going to go into all my towns and recruit a governor where it's needed. Of course, I'm not going to do one here in Agrica because we're waiting for someone to come on by. But in Lilybaum, we're going to, let's see if we can actually recruit someone. We can, so we're going to go ahead and do that. Now, even my quote-unquote occupied territories like Polentia, unfortunately, I'm not able to recruit anyone. I'm going to probably have to send someone over. Probably this 16-year-old, actually, that's learning here in Rome. Appius Gilo. He is my best bet. But typically in occupied territories, I don't like to think of them as governors because the territory isn't quote-unquote officially mine by my own house rules. But let's just say it's an overseer, someone making sure there is peace and order in an occupied territory. In addition, it will also prevent diplomats from bribing the town as easily. So we already have someone in Saguntum, Emporiae. We have an overseer. Of course, we have the great Publius Cornelius Scipio over here in Bicor, and we do have an acting interim overseer in Gadir, so we just need someone in Carthago Nova, and I think I actually am able to, yes, I can recruit my own general there, so that will be great. So we only have to worry about Polentia, I think, as far as, yeah, we got Agrica, Lilybaum we just did, Carthago Nova, yeah, Polentia is the only thing that we have to worry about, and we'll just have to be patient when it comes to that. Now, one last thing for those of you, for your whole suggestion, I think I'm going to limit the garrison here to one full stack and then also a garrison, so I will probably in the next turn or so combine these two up into like a full strong stack and then just defend Dyrrhachium that way. I really don't want to abandon Dyrrhachium, to tell you the truth. It's not very Roman. Romans fought for their land, they were very proud for what they conquered, and they didn't just give up easily. So, but this is another resource. If you think that I could take some of these forces and use them on another front, go ahead. If you think I might as well just save the money and disband them, that's another idea as well. Alright, so building for this turn is pretty limited. I've decided to build, well, now that Genoa has actually grown to a kind of a small province of her own, the public order isn't great, so I'm making her a client state. In addition, we also have Emporiae, just some rural community control, something to up our population, because whether I'm fighting against the Galaci or the Carthaginians, you know, some more men in a controlled territory in Iberia is definitely necessary. And then finally, Region, we're just going to build ourselves a nice Shrine of Juno. Alright, so that does it for this session. I was just about to press the end turn button, and then I stopped myself, because I realized what I wanted to do. So I look forward to reading your comments, and yeah, thank you very much for watching. I'm sorry that this was a bit of a short episode, but that's alright. The next ones will be much, much longer.